There once was a time when the universe, plants, animals, men and gods were the same thing. There once was a time when men knew the vital and creative energy that existed in all things of the universe, and they considered it their great mother. They called her Astarte, Ishtar, Kali, Demeter, Isis, Ostara, Freya, Chicomecoatl, the most ancient and widely worshipped divinity in human history. Shrines to her were built in the Neolithic period. She represented nature, female fertility, the instinctive, irrational, and intuitive spirit, the right side of the brain. She was the mistress of creation and destruction. She was the light of the world. She was virgin, bride, mother, prostitute, and witch. Then, one day of some 4,000 years ago, a group of patriarchs of a tribe of nomadic Hebrews, tired of her playfulness and of her changeable moods, led a coup against her, preferring a male god, cold, rational, aggressive, a god finally useful to wars, conquests, and battles for power. This ancient god, this Jehovah and his cult, have made the history of our Western world. He blotted out the Great Mother, demonized the essence of her femininity, and recognized in the female and instinctual part of men the base of all objections. That day, the orgiastic and irrational god, who up to that moment represented the male aspect of nature, became the big enemy. He was no more called Pan, and then was born the devil. Then one day, of 500 years ago, men from the West came to conquer new lands in Mexico, and people embraced him as their ancestor, as a spirit. He brought with him a god absolutely good, absolutely perfect and superior. In the name of that god, this man judged the spirits, the energies, and the pre-Columbian gods, and found that they were evil. To civilize men who fed themselves with their own enemies, being that a form of respect for their energy, this man started burning them on pyres in order to make them understand what was good. And so the devil appeared, even in Mexico. Not 100 years have passed since the last pyres have stopped burning. Others have destroyed ritual centers, burned sacred effigies, sent shamans to pyres, but miraculously, their millenarian knowledge has somehow survived. Demonizing the magic and the irrational, of course, will not change the structure of the universe or of the human being. Nor will it change the curiosity. Sometimes it will assume forms of folklore or superstition, but nevertheless, it will always remain as a necessity, a profound need. Here in this multi-ethnical, proud, and contradictory Mexico, the word magic can rarely mean anything. And here we have a valid example of that. Thank you. If you have a passion for occultism, if you're interested in white, red, or black magic, if you're looking for a love filter, if you have a weakness for black cats, toads, or bats, and you need a luck pendant with paws of coyote or eagle talons, then certainly the Sonora Market in Mexico City is for you. It's hard to imagine something you couldn't find in this bizarre place. Here, sweet and reassuring family mothers find ingredients to make faithful their husbands, make ill their neighbors, and find a bridegroom for their daughter.
Para las viudas, para la buena suerte. Esto también es para la suerte de las casas. Esto es para limpio de personas.
Here they have live animals to be sacrificed in rituals, dead men's bones to prepare mixtures, dolls to hurl away death spells. Here you can find the toloache, a potion made of datura stramonio, the devil's grass, with which generations of chaste Mexican girls have stupefied rude men from the woods until they've married them.
Para el dinero. Y para todo, para problemas, para paz en la casa y para el negocio. Se pone así. En la persona, o en el negocio, o en su casa.
¿Y ya?
Ya, da la suerte.
¿Pero sirve o no sirve?
Sí, sirve. ¿No, qué pasa?
And more. Books of incantations, flowers to free yourself from spells, devil masks, little idols of all sorts, crosses of all dimensions for cheap prices. If you ask, they can recommend the right spray for your necessities and the right stone for your sign. And if you pay attention to the huckster, you can purchase a medicine that cures exactly 27 ills and a couple of inferiority complexes.
5 minutos nada más, y si no se quita, me dice lo que quiera. Mijos, váyanse a jugar por allá. Córranle, a gritar por allá. Mire, fíjese bien, esto que yo le enseño es importante y si la gente tiene un poco de preparación, yo le voy a enseñar, bendito sea el Señor. Y te voy a regalar un poco de la hierba, nomás quiero que aprendas a usarla. No me la vaya a servir al trancazo, ¿eh? No vayas a querer agarrar un montón de hierbas y las vaya a servir al fregarazo, al trancazo, porque ellos ya que se han usado dando magnífico resultado. Rompe el paquetito, échalo adentro, ciérralo bien y déjalo remojado de hoy para mañana, ¿me entendiste? Ya que esté de color verde negro, verde mar, está listo para curarse. Esto te sirve para curar 27, ¿oíste bien? 27.
And if the problem is too big and you can't manage by yourself, there's always a school of magicians around, for all tastes and for all pockets.
Un ejemplo de lo que de nuestros chamanes mexicanos, ¿sí? De ciertos rituales que nosotros tenemos en nuestro México. Pero para que yo te explique todo esto, el significado, tienes que venir, como te digo, para que yo tenga mis cosas y tu trabajo y así nos ponemos de acuerdo.
But let's leave apart now the superstitions and the sprays and go back to something more serious. In Mexico City, at number 25, in the little house number 7, lives Don Honorio, 104 years old, a shaman, a Freemason, Knight of the Rosicrucian Order, student of esotericism, decorated with the Legion of Honor for civil merits, a man of a disconcerting culture and agility, a self-taught philosopher. The first thing he asked was if we'd paid attention to the numbers. We had. 7 and 7. Pythagoras said it. Don Honorio knows about Pythagoras, and he lives in two small rooms, illuminated only by his knowledge. He practically cured our whole crew. Six incredulous rationalists came away from his house a little less ailed, a little less incredulous, and a little less rationalist.
A ver. Entonces podemos enlazarla con las creencias de las distintas religiones, de que dicen que todo emana de Dios y que Dios está en todas partes. Es la manifestación de la energía. ¿Qué cosas son las energías? Las energías son una... Pues toda energía es invisible, pero es omnipotente. Y de energías está lleno el universo entero, porque las energías se manifiestan en el orden material como fuerza, como movimiento, pero en el mundo este de las energías se presenta como una potencia que se pone en vibración, y la materia pues también es energía. Por eso Einstein decía que todos los cuerpos irradian ondas estáticas de su propia índole, y decía que la materia es energía condensada.
Before the division of science into staunch compartments, the man of knowledge, the wise man, did not represent the hyperfine specialist of a single particular of the universe, but the one who was able in some way to join together rational and intuitive perception, religion and experience. Trying to harmonize all of the aspects of their knowledge, the ancient wise men created parallelisms and metaphors which our modern science is little by little confirming. Paradoxes, waves of probability, the horizon of events and antimatter are not expressions drawn from a science fiction book, but basic terms with which modern physics tries to express new ideas and which reveal a fundamental problem. The rational perception is, in fact, as Fridtjof Capra says, a system of abstract concepts and symbols, characterized by a linear and sequential structure. It's a system typical of our way of thinking and speaking that cannot be found in the structure of the universe, nor in that of the nuclear world. The natural world is a complex and multidimensional world. It's a world without straight lines and regular forms, in which things do not occur in sequence, but all at the same time. Theories widely accepted in the field of physics present the universe around us, and of which we are a part, as a four-dimensional whole. However, with those that we consider our true senses, we cannot make any direct experience of the four-dimensional world of space and time. It seems as if we have lost the capacity to perceive it, as if we've closed that which the Indians called the third eye.
Me enteré de que en la primitiva humanidad, la primer arte o ciencia que ellos conocieron fue la curación. Y eso lo hacían poniendo las manos encima del dolor para quitarlo, o poniendo las manos para detener la sangre que salía de las heridas, pero no solamente era una energía que ponían en práctica con la cuestión de las manos, sino también era la fuerza mental, el pensamiento. Esas energías están acumuladas aquí en el plexo solar. Así es que la energía es un elemento curativo.
Don Honorio told us about the Olmeca. He explained that the diffusion of a great number of the magical rituals in Central America followed the course of Olmeca's passage from north to south. He told us how deep was the knowledge that these very ancient people had once reached.
En los Olmecas, la noche, la oscuridad de la noche, era la que en sí tenía el germen de la verdad, porque estaba oculta la verdad, porque no, por la oscuridad no se venían las cosas, pero cuando venía la luz era la verdad que aclarecía y se veía la forma y el objeto a donde pegaba la luz. Entonces, esa oscuridad tenía en sí el germen de la verdad. Ahora, la verdad solamente se lograba con investigación. Y de esa noche es de donde le dieron, adoraron el jaguar como símbolo de la noche. Y eso, del jaguar lo escogieron por sus manchas que tiene, y que así en el cielo también se veía por las estrellas. Ese es el dios principal de los olmecas. Van con el doctor y le dicen, pues siento este malestar, que las piernas, que las siento pesadas, que me siento cansado, que de los brazos, que a veces se me caen las cosas como si no tuviera fuerzas, que siento aquí una pesadez, que a veces me agacha la cabeza. Empiezan a decirle de eso. El doctor empieza a examinarlo. Ah, de las piernas es por la circulación de la sangre. De los brazos es que también son otras extremidades que la circulación de la sangre no llega. Que de la cuestión de la pesadez del cerebro es que su corazón no está trabajando bien y son el que hay la presión alta, la presión baja, y le atribuye a esas cosas. Y ninguna de esas cosas es verdad. Esas son las energías que sirven para venir a perjudicar a media humanidad y causarle daños. Todos los trabajos que se llaman de brujería son energías que vienen a causar malestares en el cuerpo. No dolencias, malestares. Y de eso viene un desequilibrio también mental. La mente se atrofía. Entonces, el individuo en cualquier problema, por simple y sencillo que vea, en lugar de encontrar la solución, se enreda más, pero no hay un desequilibrio biológico. Entonces los doctores se estrellan ante estos males y no curan a ninguno de estos, porque ellos están viendo los desequilibrios biológicos, pero no han visto ni han aceptado la cuestión de las energías.
However, something in our Western world culture is rapidly changing. To prove it is this meeting of indigenous medicine of all the Americas, organized by the National Institute of Native Cultures, backed by the Mexican government, and supported by Americans. This event is the result of a new politics of the revaluation of popular knowledge. A politics that has permitted medicine men from different countries and cultures to meet and to exchange their experiences about the art of therapy, a science whose origins lie in the darkness of time. Cultures we thought dominated by superstition reveal instead to be deeply aware of the human and cosmic vicissitudes. The next stop of our journey was Chichicastepec, a solitary village lost in the middle of Sierra Mije. Four little houses surrounded by mountains in a place where it always rains. 12 hours by jeep to arrive from Oaxaca, and 5 hours of walking under the rain with all the equipment on our shoulders. We'd already been there 3 years ago, and all sorts of things had happened to us. Now, we would have done anything to avoid that place, but we couldn't. Why? In this place, with the help of INI, there's been inaugurated the first clinic of traditional medicine of all Central America. The Institute of Native Cultures put the money and vaccines, people put in their work, and the curanderos brought the magic. 9 healers, 8 women and 1 man, an explosive mixture. They knew about our arrival, and they said they agreed. But once there, they didn't want to anymore. Or better, they couldn't. In fact, the government of the village has passed from the hands of the Catholics to those of the Protestants, and these have started a battle against superstition and against traditional medicine, sending away the healers and leaving the clinic in the hands of three improvised nurses. The pictures you're seeing now are in fact borrowed from a documentary film made a couple of years ago by Eni. The only traditional ritual that has survived the depuration is the temazcal, a sort of tonic sauna of obvious profane traits, and a few tisanes made of herbs. Feeling very disconcerted, after having passed half of our day in showing papers and presentations in order to get the permission from the Council of Elders to do the shootings, we took our movie camera and went around by ourselves. The man spoke to us. The women didn't show up.
¿Ustedes es católico?
Más o menos. Es el mismo gospel.
¿Es católico ustedes o qué?
Es corte católica. Es católica.
Es que no sabe, pues, la religión, pues, no crece de católico, de, no es como medio. Habla usted que ya le dije, que desde que habla usted.
Por nosotros, católica.
Católica.
Sí.
Sí. Usted es curandero, ¿verdad?
Antes era.
No, fue el curandero, pero hoy también no fue.
Chupador. Sí. Es chupador.
Como hay enfermedades, porque muchas gentes pasó así, pero esto ya tiene mucha sangre panchada. Sí. Nada más que está chupar. Sí. A veces son hasta negras. Mi papá diga. Sí, mi papá enseñó. Antes, cuando está chica todavía, pues. Nomás limpia con alcohol, con algodón, nomás poquito tome de mezcal cuando empezar a chupar. Y después, cuando ya terminó, también los con el mezcal, con eso está clavo en la boca, le tiro. Porque no quiero gente.
No quiero porque agarra, porque come la enfermedad, así dicen. ¿Cómo lo saca, pues? Tiene brujería, es brujería también. ¿Cómo lo saca también? Pues alguien, a veces uno saca piedra, a veces saca un vidrio, un pedazo, lo que sabe mucho, ¿no? Esa es brujería, ¿no? Enseñan para que creemos, ¿no? Mejor pura medicina, ¿no? Es lo que dicen otros, ¿no?
Sus mayores topiles a meterle en la cárcel, ese brujo, a multar.
Ese brujo.
¿Por qué? Por eso estamos a agarrar, a meter ahí en la cárcel, a multarnos. Mejor sale por acá, anda por ahí, pues, ¿a dónde?
Se va a otro pueblo también, sale aquí, se corre pues y se va.
Sí, parece ya no.
Ya no puede.
Three years ago, when we met him, he told us about the shamans who went flying to meet in a cave near Oaxaca. He explained to us about the ritual with which he was able to find the soul of those who've lost it. And he promised that he would have shown it to us. But now he was scared even to talk about it.
Porque hay tabaco de acá. Hay por acá nomás. Con eso lo tapan a comer humo.
¿De tabaco?
Sí, nada más. Un poquito de picante. Dos, tres. Pero a poner lumbre, entonces sí. Nada más. Quite, se quite, brujo.
It's incredible how devastating can be the effects that intolerance and dogmatism of any color and of any belief may have on people's cultures. Having no intention of going away with our tail between our legs, we decided to return to our witch, for she was the only woman healer that we've managed to see there. We went to her with our movie camera turned on to thank her for her wonderful hospitality, for the infinite kindness offered to people who arrived from the other part of the world. Magic for magic, we would have told what she didn't want to say. And the magic of television can sometimes do miracles. A miscalculated gesture and an excess of self-conceit on our side that we don't suggest to anyone. At this point, just like 3 years ago, when we almost didn't want to talk to her anymore, she decides, she invites us, and she explains.
Ah, mi trabajo, ay Dios, Padre mío, ahí está Dios, Dios lo está oyendo todo eso. Como por ejemplo, yo ahora sí, pues eso es lo que yo estoy haciendo para ayudar a la humanidad, para ayudar a nuestro prójimo. Como hizo Jesús cuando Jesús anduvo en el continente. Cuando Jesús sanó los ciegos, los cojos, los paralíticos. Y Jesús mismo vino a enseñar y Él dejó su enseñanza que va a haber personas, que hay personas lo que va a hacer así también tal como hizo Jesús, pero no hacer cosas para perjudicar más a la humanidad. Eso es lo que Dios no quiere. Eso es lo que yo estoy haciendo.
La magia negra es para causar males, la magia blanca para quitarlos. La brujería negra es para causar males, la brujería blanca es para quitarlos. Todas esas cositas son duales, como en el universo entero todo es dual. Todo es luz y sombra, todo es bien y mal. Todo son los extremos.
It's this dualism that's the pivot of Mexican shamanism, in which the tonal and the nahual are the extremes of the one and the all. The tonal represents the world of everyday, with all its certainties, habits and conventions. The nahual appears as the world of energies, an immense and unknown world that perhaps we can manage but not rationalize. Here, like anywhere else, neither of the two extremes excludes the other, and there's no scale of values among them. They simply compenetrate one another like the Chinese yin and yang, or like matter and antimatter, of which modern physicians talk in order to describe the universe.
¿Y los brujos quién son?
Bueno, pues muchos dicen que sí hay brujos, pero como por ejemplo aquí de este pueblito, aquí, que sí de veras no hay ni una bruja en lo que sabe lo que es o lo que sabe hacer cosas brujerías. Aquí no hay ni una brujería. Sí, lo que le perjudica a la humanidad. Lo que trabajamos aquí son con pura hierba, con partera. Yo soy partera, también atiendo partos. Y el señor Leandro, el chupador. Pues así ayudamos a nuestro prójimo. Sí.
Sí, está feo, ¿eh?
Está feo.
Aquí ya comienza lo feo.
Estamos acostumbrados.
The next day, when we went back to the car, exhausted by kilometers of climbing, after only 10 meters, the Jeep got bogged down in a puddle near a place which was sliding down and dropping sheer into a gorge. After hours of useless attempts, we found a truck that pulled us out. A tire was punctured. The car jack didn't work. The four-wheel drive stopped working, and the lights, every now and then, turned off for a moment. It was a supply of 7 kinds of incense that saved us, and some paternoster said in a low voice for embarrassment. After hours of going slowly because of the fog, we reached a shack in the middle of nowhere. A young man was selling gasoline there, and 2 sweet girls were serving caldo de pollo fumante. Then we finally understood what the ancients meant when they spoke about fairies.
Sí, señor, es mi son, cómo no, cómo no. Bailador, bailador, vengo el son, sí, señor, cómo no. Sí, señor, es mi son, cómo no, cómo no. Bailador, bailador, vengo
From the mountains to the coast, to Mixteca Baja, halfway between Acapulco and Puerto Escondido. So close and yet so far away from blonde American surfers who come down in flocks to enjoy the waves of the Pacific. In the midst of conflicts and difficulties of the Mixteca people, to whom Spanish conquerors not only introduced rich mestizo landowners, but also a populace of the down and outs, sons of Negroes once imported as slaves. With these people, they have to live together and struggle for miserably paid jobs and the little humanitarian aid that arrives once in a while. It's a prolific land, good for coffee, maize, sugarcane, but it's also a land of a few, where to survive means to struggle every day for food. Here, amongst these people with a very low literacy, where only a minority speaks Spanish, the figure of the shaman identifies with that of the leader, of the man who represents and defends the community in her relationships with the external world, and who acts as a mediator with everyday problems. This is Don Maximiliano Flores, leader of the indigenous coffee cultivators of the coast, an uncomfortable representative of a community of natives who are now starting to organize themselves, refusing to undersell their work to rich landowners and trying instead to establish their own economic autonomy.
Nosotros los curanderos o hierberos curamos unas enfermedades que los médicos institucionales no pueden curar. Por decir así, cuando la enfermedad es por un espanto, que sea por una maldad de ojo, que sea un aire de muerto, o que sea por hechicería, eso lo curamos nosotros. Cuando uno también es chingón, uno va a curar, pero tiene uno que cerrar las puertas primero. No la puerta de la casa, no. Debe uno cerrar primero al paciente. Se va a ensomar con sahumerio, el humo. Da una vuelta alrededor de la casa y y así cierra uno, pues. Entonces el brujo ya no puede hacer nada. Y ahí, encerrando la casa o al paciente en esa forma, automáticamente se empieza a hacer las curaciones y el brujo va a perder. ¿Sí? Va a perder porque ya no va a surtir efecto su trabajo.
He sufrido de un dolor de pulmones y un dolor de muela. Ya después del dolor de muela me empecé a entumir, ¿no?, del cuerpo. Y nada más porque no me daba calentura, nada más, puro dolor de cuerpo y un dolor de estómago. Era lo que a mí me mataba, pues, dolor de cabeza. Pues sí, es que, pues, yo creo que sí me hicieron algo, pues, no sé por qué lo hicieron, pues.
Por envidia, porque vivían ellos allá en el centro. Por esa misma razón se salieron, se vinieron para acá, para que ya no haya problemas.
Sí, pues, nada más por pura envidia, porque casi, pues, nosotros la gente no le hacemos nada, pues.
Y con la curación que se le hizo la primera vez, con la misma curación que se le hizo, devolvió, vomitó y sudó mucho y sintió el cuerpo un temblor cuando salió el espíritu malo. Y ahorita le vamos a dar otra limpia para ver cómo sigue, si ya va menorando la enfermedad o sigue igual. Esto vamos a hacer un diagnóstico, al mismo tiempo se le va a hacer una limpia.
En nombre del Padre, el Espíritu Santo, Jesús, gloria al Padre, gloria al Hijo.
Uno limpia el huevo, y quiebra el huevo en un vaso de agua, y allí va a marcar si esa enfermedad hecho por los brujos, allí va a salir, y si es una enfermedad que es aire de muerto, allí va a salir, si es una enfermedad que es por maldad de ojo, allí va a salir. Cuando es ojo, se forma el ojo de la gente. Ojo, así como los ojos que tenemos, así se forma. Es como un diagnóstico. Al mismo tiempo se está curando. Y el huevo está absorbiendo todo lo que tiene el cuerpo. El huevo lo absorbe porque está vivo. Si salió limpio el huevito, pues esto es para médico. Vete que tiene un tratamiento. Tenemos buenos contactos con los médicos.
In this manner, The equilibrium that has been altered compounds again, thanks to the mediation of the healer, the presence of the group, and the precise will of the ill person. The illness in this manner is not an objective fact, but a phenomenon perceived as a consequence of some other cause, of something that's generated the disharmony with the all. And here is the rite, the map to create again the equilibrium. Complex, unintelligible, but at the same time very simple. It seems like suggestion, a placebo effect, or the therapy of the pilgrimage. It's all this together and something more inexplicable and more irrational, something possible to be accomplished, but not comprehensible. Not comprehensible in terms of logical thinking, but perfectly acceptable in terms of magic.
Vamos a ver el huevito. Ahorita ya no se le ve nada, nada de que se vea un humo adentro del vaso, ya no se le ve eso. Esto que sale aquí son, son señales de que ahorita ya tiene aire el cuerpo, pero ya es un aire normal. Entonces ahorita lo que quiere el cuerpo es vitaminarse.
He then introduced us to a colleague of his, a man about 60 years old, who at first sight seemed heavily drunk. He spoke with a drawling voice, mincing his words, and sometimes half-closing his eyes, and interrupting the dialogue as if he was having sudden sleep attacks. He disconcerted us. He's a pulseador, a healer, whose specific task is to find out the illness by feeling the blood flux. He started with the right pulse, then with the left. While on a piece of paper, he drew a figure of a man, trying to explain, in terms of the excess of warm and cold, the anomalies he was finding. Then he passed to our ankles, following the same operation. The conclusion and the clinical picture he did of us was astonishing for its exactness. In only half an hour, our sensation of speaking to a drunk man had completely changed into great admiration. These are the danzantes, the rain men. During their continuous pilgrimage, shrouded by a sacred halo, there's not a city or a village of central and northern Mexico where they do not stop. It's said that with the brewing rhythm of their dances, they evoke the clouds and make the rain come down. A reminiscence, a bit folkloristic, of ancient pre-Columbian dances, a chameleon transformation in entertainments for feasts of patrons. Like this feast, held in honor of a certain Saint Francis of Assisi, whom they say was born in a place not specified on the other side of the mountain. This part of our journey is now also concluded. And if by chance you have a slight feeling of something missing inside of you, don't get angry. We feel the same way. Besides, so out of context, so demonized and alienated, the shamans at the end seem really a bit like Martians. Without respect for their role, and without regard for the sacredness of their feats, they indeed remain all alone in front of the infinite. The theme of our following journey will be the wise man's and the shaman's search for the individual gesture to accomplish in front of the infinite, the search for illumination.